The following opinions are solely those of BoatTEST.com and its test captain.
Hi, Captain Steve for BoatTEST.com, and today I'm on the 275 series from Yamaha. This comes in three versions each with increasing levels of features, and it's also representing a lot of firsts for Yamaha. The first with dual SVHO engines, the first 27-footer, and the first with advanced drive technology. Let's take a look as I do a full features walkthrough and performance evaluation.
Beginning in the bow, the spacious lounge seats are extra long due to the forward quarter cushions, leaving plenty of room to stretch out. Each lounge seat has a cubby for a smartphone, a Wet Sounds Revo 6 stereo speaker, USB ports, and two cup holders. The seat cushions hinge aft and lift up, revealing storage. Each seat includes a grab handle and two armrests, one that flips down into position, not up, requiring a release from a pinch point underneath. There's a wide footwell thanks to the boat's 9-foot beam, 6 inches more than in the 242 series, allowing for plenty of room for a side mount pedestal table that creates an entertaining venue forward. The 275SD upholstery is made with 4 different colors of vinyl, something we rarely see on any size boat. Note the upscale diamond stitching, bead welding in the seat, and the raised head cushion on the forward-facing seat back. The aluminum grab handle is a contemporary design with angular sides, which we rarely see on any boat. Getting on and off the boat may also be done when bow docked in by removing the bow cushion, stepping on the non-skid deck, and into the boat. Additional cushions are standard and transform the bow into a large sun pad. Fully forward, the anchor locker has a heavy-duty gas strut, and wiring coming down from the nav light is well protected as required by ABYC standards. Just behind is the logoed C-deck trim. To the sides are two of the boat's 7 6-inch cleats. The bow can be closed off from the cockpit by pulling down a fabric wind dam and closing the walkthrough windshield. The cockpit entertaining area is quite spacious and practically laid out in the Yamaha 275 series to maximize functionality. The companion seat amenities include 3 of the 19 cup holders on this boat, a USB port, a pocket for quick drop items, and a 2-inch wide aluminum grab handle. A courtesy light is above. To the side, we see another unusual design element that sets the Yamaha 275SD apart from other runabouts in class. Note how the side windshield abuts the side window frame, creating a protected zone for the companion. The arched side window is slightly higher than my head and extends aft beyond the seat. This is a major and welcome design feature of the boat. Just ahead of the companion seat, the dash area is outfitted with a non-glare vinyl brow. Below are drink holders, a padded cubby, and lockable storage below. The handle on the left opens to reveal a head. In the compartment, there's 3 feet 8 inches of headroom, 2 feet 8 inches over the toilet. The portable toilet is standard, and there's a countertop, a pull-out shelf, closed and open storage, and a push-activated light above. Between the helm and companion seats is a large index storage compartment, and additional storage is right alongside in the helm console. Just behind the helm seat is a food prep console with open counter space. To the back is a beverage holder and covered sink. Below is a drawer, and below that is a pull-out 30-quart cooler. A smaller version of this console is on the E and SE models, while this SD version adds this extra section. There are port and starboard bench seats that can seat as many as 7 people. Since both the companion seat and the helm seat swivel around, 2 more seats can be added to the party. Because of the boat's 9-foot beam, she's able to have a full 4 feet of deck space between the bench seats. On the starboard side, the seat back wraps around at the front, creating an aft-facing section. The forward-facing seats can serve as chaise seating. All of the cockpit seating opens to reveal storage. Inside the port seat are the engine battery switches. Under the aft seats are heavy-duty plastic trays that, when removed, allow access to the engine compartments. Note the sound-absorbing material under the hatches. 2 of the ship's batteries can be seen on the port side. The snap-in carpet throughout the boat comes standard. Vinyl along the gunnels of the main cockpit has the same 4-tone color scheme as the bow, creating an upscale and cozy look. Along the port side are 2 of the boat's 6 speakers, a beverage holder, grab handle, and shelf. All of this is under the protection of the hardtop 7 feet 3 inches off the deck. It's well supported with 2¼-inch powder-coated rails that also serve as grab handles. In the center are 2 skylights, but being the fair-skinned Irish boy that I am, I'd like to see the ability to block the sun and have UV protection. Above is a fixed anchor light. Bow seats transform by simply pulling this loop and moving the backrest forward, which converts the seating into huge, aft-facing chaise lounges for when we're not underway. There's a speaker, grab handle, and storage cubby to the side. A table can mount to the transom to increase the entertainment capability. A standard filler cushion converts the dual seats into a large sun pad. Rather than a hinged gate, there's a drop-in divider to close off the walkthrough. Both port and starboard seats lift up on gas assist struts to reveal the clean-out ports to the jet drive. The engines have kill switches for safety when the hatch is opened. There's also easy access to a water fill and the engine freshwater flush intake. The 275SD has a full-beam swim platform that also doubles as a wide seating area with comfortable backrests. Drink holders are to port and starboard. There's a centerline swim ladder, something not possible on stern drive boats, and two handholds on the transom. Side steps for boarding and leaving the boat also double as armrests. There's a shower wand and the remote stereo control. Yamaha's latest innovation is dual-purpose tables/seats that slip into the bracket below the swim platform. In one position, they're elevated tables. In the down position, they're underwater seats. We had to be in the water to put them in, but that's the whole point of these seats anyway. The surprising part? They float. And we verified that they float. Keep in mind, there are no exposed drives or propellers anywhere behind or under the boat, so taking better advantage of this space was creative indeed. Now let's look at our operational features. As we said earlier, the aft lounge seating sections lift up via heavy-duty gas struts, and beneath are the removable trays that come out to reveal both engine compartments, housing the twin 1.8-liter supercharged, super vortex, high-output, and intercooled Yamaha engines, producing 250 horsepower each. The supercharger is placed on the forward end of the block and runs off the main crankshaft, forcing large volumes of air in a compressed space through the intercooler. This four-stroke engine is connected directly to its 160mm 8-vane jet pump unit, which sucks in water from below the bottom through what Yamaha calls a top-loader grate, which directs more smooth water into the pump for better performance. Saving the best for last, let's take a look at this helm. It features a well-thought-out ergonomic design and speaks to the upscale quality that Yamaha is signaling for this latest launch. Front and center is the 12-inch Connext multifunction display serving as the hub for all functions, including the vessel's electrical switching, gauges, controls for cruise and water sports functions, and even the entertainment controls. We're currently in float mode, which gives us water temperature and Bluetooth functionality. All the vessel switching, we can go to media. We can go to drive control, which gives us acceleration curves for skiers. We can go to trip info, which is all resettable info. We can also go to a moving map display, of course, and we can move in as desired. We have a home page that gives us our speed, and we can change all of our settings. Notice on the side, we've always got fuel and depth, and controls along the bottom, which are going to be most important, including the drive control. Now notice that we're in float mode. When I start the engines, it switches over to RPMs. Now we're in running mode. And all of this is not only controllable from the touchscreen, it's also controllable from the joystick over on the right-hand side that works just like a mouse joystick with the touchscreens above. The most significant change to the helm is the drive control. Two paddles on the steering wheel allow control of the throttle and shift so we can dock the boat from a standing position without taking our hands off the wheel. The right paddle moves the boat forward, the left reverses. Remember the phrase, go right ahead. Squeeze the paddles further and add power, limited to docking speeds, of course. All this makes her a dream around the dock. It's all remarkably intuitive and so effective that we're going to have a separate video on it. Be sure to look for it. The helm seat has flip-up armrest, a bolster, reclining and swivel functions. Notice the multiple tones, custom embroidery, and diamond stitch patterns, all speaking of the upscale theme of the 275. Now let's see how she performs. The Yamaha 275SD has a length overall of 27 feet, a 9-foot beam, and weighs 5,466 pounds dry. With 60% fuel in her 90-gallon tank, 3 people on board, and 50 pounds of gear, we had an estimated test weight of 6,507 pounds. Clearly, we tested on a rainy day with 100% humidity and a temperature of 89 degrees, none of which will get the most horsepower out of the engines, but we tested her anyway, as we do. Cranking her up to 7,400 RPM, we hit a top speed of 50.2 miles per hour. We found best cruise to be at 5,500 RPM, where she went 31 miles per hour and got 1.8 miles per gallon for a range of 147 statute miles with a 10% reserve of fuel left in the tank. Because the 275 is a jet boat, we expected fast hole shot times from her, and we were not disappointed. Her time to plane was 2.4 seconds, which is impressive because of her weight. Time recorded to 20 miles per hour was 5.9 seconds, and 30 came and went in 8.4 seconds. It's easy to be impressed with the handling characteristics with Yamaha. Her jet pump takes in more water the faster she goes, and this helps her gain traction in the turns and avoid the slide and spin out we often see with jet boats. When putting her into a hard turn, the power drops just a bit, and then when straightening out, you can feel the power come back in, like shifting into another gear. With flatcom lake conditions, we had only crossing wakes to judge her choppy water capabilities, and we found no hull slap or adverse spray. In fact, we couldn't get her to take spray at all. All this, of course, is overshadowed by her excellent handling at the dock, thanks to the new drive system that really is a game changer.
Well, clearly, we've got a boat with improvements to all three social zones, more space inside thanks to the wider beam, an extended social zone off of the swim platform, and new technology that really makes it easy to handle around the dock. It's all coming together in the 275 series from Yamaha. And that's my full features inspection and performance evaluation. For BoatTEST.com, I'm Captain Steve. We'll see you on the water.